All right. So in this tutorial, we will show how to, you know, rig a character using a 3 Pro for then later, you know, retarget the motion from Plask into the character. So let's get started. So first of all, we need to select the parts that are like not connect to like the clothes, like just the body, you know, just the body. In this case, just this man. So what we're going, well, the shoes too, I think, you know, they are pretty important. I mean, they're important because they're like in a shape that is like more separate from, you know, the clothes, because this cloth, for them to work correctly, they have another process that I will show you. Alright, so first select these ones, and now click on object press mark, get select objects, full body. Okay, so we add like the neck, chin, shoulders, wrists, and the spine root. Finally, the ankles. We have like 5 fingers, that's right. Well, in this case, I already have some of the rigs in this Blender file, so I will turn off this selection, you know, overwrite existing rig. I will turn it off. Right, so let's press OK. We wait a few seconds, and you know, you see, everything is working well. You see here, there is some mistake with the fingers, so you know, you have like manually select like the bone and manually correct these little artifacts here. For example, here too, you know. This sometimes happens, it's actually pretty common. So now, as you see, everything is like looking correct. Well, maybe a little, yeah. Alright, so now it's looking alright. So now, once that we have the armature, we go where we're in post mode. Now we go to object mode, and now go to the grid pro panel, click on match 3, press OK. And you see, we already have here the contour rig. And now, for binding the model to the contour rig, first, I will first begin connecting, like, I would say, everything all at once at first, but then we will make some tweaks for the model to look, you know, better. You know, we don't select the hair because the hair is going to be attached to the rig later. So now that we have this, we select the armature. Now we go to skin, bind, but before that, in binding settings, we choose box slice. Then one is actually better because it has like more accurate binding, you know, when binding the object meshes to the armature. So we all select a bind. It takes so a bit of time, maybe some seconds. Depends on the computer spec, you know, the CPU memory. This something happens here, but I will just let it like this. Alright, so that was like tiny mistake. The scale fix, I think it will be actually better. As you see, sometimes there are like some minor bugs when doing this. So I will do it like in a more traditional way, I think. I will do it again, but this time we scale fix. You see now, it's working correctly. Yeah, you know, it's sometimes a bit of experimentation, like, it's important. Also, yeah, you notice when we move the fingers, you'll notice this weird bar. So a way to fix this is by going like just selecting the point that the mesh contains the fingers, and then we go to select the armature, and instead of the AI box slice, we use heat masks. We fully combine. We don't use the split part since it's just the hand, so unselect that. nobody. And as you see now, it's working. It's working pretty well. So, you know, it's working pretty good. I use local and individual origins, you know, when I want to use some of the things manually. So you see now we have, well, and last thing would be like, you see there are some, this wallet actually wants some tweaking here. For hair, select the hair mesh, then select with shift the armature, then we press control tab and press and select just the head bone, meaning the head control bone. We press control P, and we click on bone. Now should be working fine. As you see here, there is like some mistakes because, you know, this being like automatically creates just some bugs. So the way to fix this, you know, ain't there just like part of this, so the process is actually quicker. I'm going to use a modifier called data transfer that will automatically like adjust all the way painting so it doesn't look like it's marrying with the body. So in source, we select the body. Now click on generate data layers. We click on vertex data, vertex groups, and on mapping we select nearest face interpolated. Now we press apply. And as you see now, you can wall there. And you see here, the bends, there's so like this weird bar where like it's moving. And you know, it doesn't look good. Well, I think it will just hide this one because it's not going to be shown in the final product. So, you know, we select this one. We press on data transfer. And again, we do the same thing. We select the source, you know, the body. Now generate data layers, vertex data, vertex groups. And now we click on nearest face interpolated. And we click on apply. And what does this do? That, you know, it fixes like that bug that was going on here. You see here, there's just some bug with that, with the shoe. So I will we'll just do the same thing with this one, just for the sake of getting better results. Now we are getting this one. You know, those are like some artifacts that then will need like some cleanup. You know, I will better go using the white paint usable method of this one. We go to the bearing group. You see here, it's like this weird thing that we don't want, so we just click on the draw, weight, the radius. I mean, those, these are like more manual things, like things that you like correct manually. I mean, they're actually very needed. In the landing stage, just press Ctrl C. It's just an easy way to do this. Now let's see how it's feeling. You know, yeah, now it's fixed. Now everything working fine. Now everything is working fine. So that's a good thing. For example, here we also see that we get these weird artifacts that, as you see, they are actually part of the mesh, at least the body. So we do the same. We go to weight paint and we find the vertex group that is making like all of our right. So it's here. So what you need to do is just like press an add and select these ones. And yeah, that's pretty much sharing. So basically this was like a tutorial to show you how to do this, like tweak these little mistakes, like you get a very good looking model, you know. And so now later, we are going to proceed, retargeting the motion using the Plask plugin. Working great, huh? It's working great.